गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, चैप्टर थर्ड, रोटेशन एंड रेवोल्यूशन. नाउ दिस इज द सेकेंड पार्ट. इन द फर्स्ट पार्ट वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट रोटेशन, इट्स इफेक्ट्स. रोटेशन इज स्पिनिंग ऑफ द अर्थ ऑन इट्स एक्सिस एंड इफेक्ट्स ऑफ रोटेशन. इट कॉजेज डे एंड नाइट एंड वी फाइंड दैट द सेलेस्टियल बॉडीज आर मूविंग जस्ट अपोजिट. लाइक सन इज मूविंग टूवर्ड्स द ईस्ट साइड एंड वाइल द अर्थ इज मूविंग फ्रॉम वेस्ट टू east direction. Now in this part we are going to study about revolution of the earth. Revolution: the earth revolves around the sun in its fixed or elliptical orbit. It takes 365 days or 365 1/4 day to complete one revolution around the sun. Elliptical orbit is like an oval shape, or you can say in a simple language like an egg. While revolving around the sun, it takes 1 year. Leap year. A leap year is a year in which an extra day is added. Just now I told you the period taken for one revolution is about 365 1/4 days. A normal year has 365 days. So the remaining fraction of 1/4 day is added once in 4 years to make a leap year of 366 days. So the month of February has 29 days instead of normal 28 days. Now it happens after every 4 years. Like the year 2000 was a leap year, then 2004, 2008. So these are the leap years. Okay, so it happens after every 4 years. Elliptic shape orbit. All planets including our earth moves on this orbit to revolve around the sun. Aphelion and perihelion. These are the two positions of the sun and earth. And this is due to elliptic orbit. The distance between the earth and the sun varies from minimum to maximum distance. Aphelion, it is a position in which ap means away from, helion means sun. So it is away from the sun, or you can say far from the sun. It happens on 5th July every year. Distance between the earth and sun is almost 152 million kilometer, while in perihelion, position of the earth is near to the sun. It happens on 3rd January. Distance between earth and sun is about 147 million kilometer. Now question can be asked, why the earth moves more quickly in its orbit when it is in perihelion than it does when the earth is in aphelion? Now you can see that this is the orbit and this position is for the aphelion and this is for the perihelion. And in this, when the earth is moving, the planets moves inward, that is toward the sun, because the distance between the sun and the earth is very less. So when it moves inward, then the speed increases, and this is because of the gravitational pull of the sun also, and because of that there is a highest orbital plane movement. The speed will be more. So when it's move quickly, then it means it's because of the gravitational force, move little bit quickly on this day. Effects of inclination of earth. Inclination of the earth is that earth is inclined on its plane, that is plane of elliptic 66.5 degree, and from the vertical it is 23.5 degree. That I had explained you already in rotation. Now here, what is the effect of this inclination on the revolution of the earth? First, change in season. Second, varying duration of day and night. Suppose earth is inclined in this, so we have different seasons. But if the position of earth is like this, like this is the axis, and if this axis is like this and earth is not tilted straight, then all the places on the earth from North Pole to South Pole will receive equal amount or equal duration of day and night. That is 12 hours of daylight and 12 hours of night. The word solstice, it means that the sun standing still or reaching the highest point while revolving around the sun. Now this is the summer solstice. In the summer solstice, you will see that the northern pole, north pole, is towards the sun, and while south pole is away from the sun. Now you can see here clearly that this is the Tropic of Cancer. Okay, and sun rays are just direct over it, that is forming a 90 degree angle. So the northern portion of northern hemisphere is getting sunlight, means North Pole is also getting sunlight for 24 hours. And here the opposite direction, we can find that here the southern pole, southern hemisphere, the southern south pole having a darkness for 24 hours. So what happened here? That the northern pole is experiencing the summer solstice, while the southern hemisphere is experiencing the winter solstice. Now, the special feature is that duration of day is longer than night in the northern hemisphere because of summer solstice. Daylight lasts for 24 hours beyond the Arctic Circle towards the North Pole. Like just give, I'm giving example. This area which is getting the sunlight for 24 hours, and North Pole, here we have a Europe. In Europe there's a place, Norway. And Norway is observing the phenomena of midnight sun. And this place continuously having the daylight from, you can say, 13th May to 29th of July. And this place becomes the tourist attraction for lot of people. Then the length of day increases with increasing latitude from the equator. Means equator is 0 degree, that is the lowest. And after that it will start increasing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Reaching to 90 degree North Pole, if we reach there, the duration of daytime increases. Winter solstice. Here you can see the position of axis. South pole is towards the sun and north pole is away from the sun. Now when you see this picture, you find that this is the Tropic of Capricorn. Sun rays is direct over the Tropic of Capricorn. So below the equator, this area is southern hemisphere and it's receiving maximum sunlight, and it is reaching up to the south pole, and it is daytime for 24 hours in the southern hemisphere. While in the northern hemisphere, what happened? North pole is away from the sun and experiencing less light, so it will be in darkness for 24 hours. So vice versa, seasons will be experienced here. In the northern hemisphere, it is summer solstice, and in the southern hemisphere, it is winter solstice. Features of winter solstice. The sun shines directly overhead Tropic of Capricorn, just I shown you. Hence, the length of day increases as one goes towards the south pole. Second, day is longer in southern hemisphere than night. So, vice versa it will take place. When the day is longer in the southern hemisphere, it is shorter in the northern hemisphere. And nights are shorter in southern hemisphere while nights are longer in northern hemisphere. Now between the Arctic Circle and North Pole, light night lasts for about 24 hours, and the entire polar areas north of Arctic Circle lies in shaded side of circle of illumination. This point can be explained like this. Here, this is the point of circle of illumination, and this area, that is the area of Arctic Circle and North Pole, that is in the darkness, while because it is on the darkness side of the circle of illumination, and this is the brighter side. So the south pole is in the dark, that is in the lighted area. It's showing the position of the different seasons while the earth is revolving around the sun. Equinox, when the sun rays are vertical over equator, either it is on 20 or 21st March and 22nd or 23rd September. Now why this variation is there? Because of the leap year. Because in the leap year it is 29 days, so because of that there is a variation in the days. Now equinox, you can see here the circle of illumination, north pole, this is the axis, north pole and south pole, direct sunrise. So according to the autumn and spring equinox, it will be vice versa in northern hemisphere or southern hemisphere. When the northern hemisphere have autumn, southern will have spring, and when northern have a spring, southern will have a autumn. Now during this equinox, what happened? All the places from north pole to south pole experiences the same amount of heat. Only this area, that is north pole and south pole, little oblique, but otherwise all the places are receiving direct sunlight. So they experience 12 hours of day and 12 hours of night. This happens twice in a year, one on the 21st of March and second on the 23rd of September. Equinox, on March 20 or 21st and September 22 or 23rd, vernal or spring and autumn equinoxes, the relation of earth to sun rays is identical. Means always during this time of spring or autumn equinox, sun rays are identical, same amount of sun rays is reaching, that is direct towards the equator. All places on the earth have 12 hours of day and 12 hours of night as circle of illumination passing from the poles, that is north pole to south pole, dividing the earth into two equal halves, that is the, you can say one is the darkness and other is lighted one. So because of that, so equinox means equal night. Both the hemisphere have the equal amount of day and equal amount of night. Thank you. I think this part of revolution of the earth is clear to you all. If any question is there, you are free to ask.